Okay, we're going to change the blades. They're double-sided blades, and they're dull on the one side, so we're going to flip them around. I'll show you the process of doing that.
First thing we're going to do is take out these 8 bolts, or 8 nuts, I mean. The bolts are welded onto the frame, but take out the 8 nuts. That'll expose the blades.
Okay, here's the insides after you take off the panel. And then you have to use a block of wood just to wedge it in there so it doesn't spin. Use your ratchet and take off that one bolt right there. Center bolt. Note that it has a keyway there to keep it from spinning. That's why it keeps it working. That's what the inside looks like there. Okay, inside. Okay, here's their wheel here from the outside. Now on the inside, there's 3 bolts right there that keep it also from turning. So you have the keyway in there, keeps it from turning. Then you get the 3 bolts on there that keep it from turning. We're going to undo those 3 bolts right now. This is a 12 millimeter bolt, and there's 2 of those in here. There were 10 millimeter bolts that go to the shaft.
Okay, so get a gear puller. I had to jerry-rig a 3/8 extension on there, 3/8 socket extension. Put it on there to get my gear puller without having to reset my holes. I want to reset it, so you can do what you got to do with your puller. Anyway, put the puller on there and just pull it straight out. We'll go to the next step. Okay.
And there she is, she's off. We'll go to the next thing. We'll make sure you remember your keyway. That's what holds it tight. And those nuts, those little 10 millimeter head nuts that go in almost all the way. They go in a long way and they hold onto it too, so keep it from spinning. Okay, we'll put it back in a second as we see how you flip them over.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this one's here, just 3 of these. Well, actually 2 of these cutters. That's the branch cutters. So when you put a branch in, they hit these here. And they're reversible also. And I've already reversed them once. And actually I have taken them off and sharpened them and then reversed them too. So I just take those 2 bolts off. You can do it without pulling this unit. You can just leave the unit on and undo these 2 nuts here. Slip it out of there. Turn it over. Put it right back in. And so that way you got the secondary. When you want to do these ones though, that's what we're doing here. That's why we took it off. We don't need to take it off for these, but we need to take it off for these because I don't know how these come off yet. They have a little Allen wrench thing right here, and I'm gonna see what happens when you take this off, see if it loosens up anything. I don't really see how this is connected yet, so once I loosen this up is the only thing I see mechanical. Once I loosen this, I'll let you know. Okay, that's a 4 millimeter Allen wrench. 4 millimeter Allen wrench. And I'm going to attempt to take that off now and find out what it does. See if we can't get a move on this thing. Okay, I'm taking the Allen wrench bolt off. And it does have a locking nut on the other side. Just grab it with a pair of pliers and twist right off. Okay, once you take off the Allen bolt and nut, that allows it to move freely. The main bolt, that's right here. You know, both, there's one on each side here. And just put a wrench on that and unscrew it. So one side's almost invisible. That's the side with the threads on it. And the other side has a little tiny bit of nub sticking out. And let's see if I can get a better shot of that. And I just grab that with a pair of pliers and unscrew it. And it'll come right out. Okay, the unscrewing of that is not really a bolt, and there are no threads. As it turns out, it's just a piece of metal that holds all together in that bolt and nut that we took out a second ago, so it holds it together. So what I'm going to do is just pull it out little by little, and as I pull it out, I'm going to flip those each one. So I'll flip them around. That'll give me the good side as opposed to the used side. The used side is all messed up, and the good side is still brand new. I'm going to flip it over. That'll make the good side there, and then we're ready to go. Again, so you understand the concept, this was where the Allen wrench bolt and nut was at.
as you push this thing down into it, you're going to reattach that. And so I just pulled it up. I stopped right there. I haven't pulled it all the way out yet. I'll flip all the blades, and I'll push it right back in. Get this thing back together again. Oh, that was nice. Just take the whole unit out, one big piece, flip it over, stick it right back in the hole, and put your pin back in. I'd venture to say the pin should go in opposite now since you're flipping it over, and the hole is closer to this side than it was to the last side. And you can see there's just two holes, though, so it doesn't matter which way it goes. Perfect. I went ahead and just took it apart, put the dividers where they were before, and all the way I'll put the plug in the way it was before with the big side sticking out. Don't know why, but didn't seem like it would make any difference. But just in case it does, why screw with it? Anyway, so simple as that. Put it back in the same way it came out. I tightened it up, and we should be ready to do the other side.
Well, that could not have gone any smoother. You just simply slipped that bolt right back in there, even without lubrication. I figured I should at least lube it, but I mean, it absolutely just slipped right back in. The nut slipped right back on. Everything's perfect. I mean, this is just great. Worked out really good. So I'm real, real pleased with the way that went. I'll do the same thing to the other side, slip it back on, and we're ready to
make it easier for you. That nut, the lock nut, is 5/16 or 8 millimeters, and it comes right off. Then you can just use your Allen wrench to hold it still, pull it right out, just make it even easier. This is it.
Okay, that went perfect as well. Real easy in and out. I went ahead and lubed that one to see if it was any easier. And, you know, the slight rust on it, so it made it a little easier, but not too bad. It was already easy. Anyway, now's a good time. If you haven't changed these blades here, the ones that do the branch cutting, these are for leaves and stuff, you know, small branches. This is when you stick it in that big hole right here for big, long branches. If you haven't turned, now's a good time since you already got it off and everything. Just go ahead and undo the two nuts, turn it over, put it back on, you're done. It's easy to sharpen them by hand. You can have a professional sharpener do it. After you've switched these blades and they're dull, then there's no, unless you find a kit, I've never seen one, but if you find a kit and replace them, now you know how to take it apart and put it all back together again. But if you don't find the kit, you might just take these things down and have them sharpened by a professional sharpener. Same thing as here, and you're ready to go again. Okay? I doubt they'll be able to put teeth back on, but at least sharp blades will do a fine job. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and put it back together, and if I have any issues with it, I'll let you know. If not, I assume it'll go right back the way we took it apart. Do make sure you line up your keyway here. You can see the keyway right there, and here's the key right inside there. It's all the way full length. And I'm just going to line it up there. Once it's in there, that keeps it from rotating. And that extra nuts help too. And so all together, it makes it real tight. Okay. Yeah, it slipped right on. And a couple of taps with the hammer just to set it. And I don't know if you can see it or not, but everything looks great. You're ready to put all the stuff back together again. So we'll put those ones back on. The two bolts there. And put in the one bolt there. And fasten all of our nuts around this thing here, and we're ready to rock.
Okay, the same thing applies. Put the block of wood in to keep it from rotating, and get it in there tight, and then just tighten that bolt. Okay, note that these bolts here don't go in all the way. They don't get sunk all the way down. Okay, see that right there? If you remember, if you can go back in the video, you'll see that they weren't down to begin with. That's sunken all the way down right there. So they don't sink all the way. They don't bottom out, in other words. That's the way they go. Okay? Nice and tight. Okay, so I got everything done. All set up. We'll go ahead and put the cover back on, and we're ready to rock and roll. Wasn't too bad. I think it took about... about a half an hour. So it took about a half an hour to pull this thing off, fix them, turn them around, put them back on. If you're doing the other blades too, you know, you might just... I was thinking it could be an hour job. But anyway, so it's pretty fast. Knock it right out. Okay? You guys enjoy.